The Moonstone was Kutaro's only ticket home to Earth. Newly armed with the ninja's bombacious powers, Kutaro continued to scour the Moonwood in search of the despicable rat. Ever since the goddess had vanished from her throne, the denizens of the Moonwood had hardly slept a wink. But then they received a visitor. A single, smartly dressed rat. "Gather round," the rat said, and produced a purple elixir. "This tincture will cure all illnesses and stave off the tyrant's magic." And he offered to sell it to them for a reasonable price as a neighborly gesture. The Moonwood's inhabitants were overjoyed and relieved to have such a good friend looking out for them.
Well, the Moonwood is a mess, all right. But where's General Rat? There's still no sign of him. At least it's nice here. Finally a place on the moon that's not crazy. Hey, Kotaro. Even if you clobber that rat and get the Moonstone Shard, you better not give it to the witch. I mean it. Seriously, that witch, she's just using you so she can get her grubby hands on the Moonstone. Or worse.
Oh, yes, Daddy. Give me the Moonstone.
And your brains.
Who knows what she'll do with that kind of power? You should leave the Moonstone with me. I can keep it safe.
What? You wouldn't dare.
That dipsqueak is even more shady than I am.
Can it, Crone? No comments from the imaginary peanut gallery. Be honest, Kotaro. Do you still not trust me? Because I think I could tell you something that might change your mind. Ready for this? My daddy is the sun. I know, it's like tragic. I'm a princess, I'm royalty. Then the Moon Bear King hits me with one lousy flash of magic. And suddenly, I'm just royally tiny. What? What's that look? I'm serious, I'm the Sun Princess.
Princess.
What?
Princess,
hey!
Princess, princess.
With the vows of friendship renewed, Kutaro and Picarina, Princess of the Sun, continued their quest to find the shattered Moonstone.
And now for Lake Cedrus.
Kutaro and Picarina were still hot on the rat's tail when they reached the edge of a dim and darksome lake.
Oh, please, someone, anyone, help! Save me from my predicament! Mayday! Mayday!
They heard the shrill cries of a damsel in distress. Lake Cedrus had been one of the Moon Realm's top tourist attractions. Until, of course, it got turned into a creepy, toxic, gut-turning pit of stink and rot.
Mama went crazy.
I mean, I'm
Mama.
Did you know?
Yeah.
Frogs are low in calories and contain high efficiency protein. Beauty in every bite.
Oh my gosh!
Living in the lake were adorable little creatures known as the Kappagaeru. But the rat's toxin had triggered a most unpleasant metamorphosis, and the few Kappagaeru who dodged that bullet now faced extinction at the hands of their psychopathic relative. In days of yore, the moon goddess herself took holidays to the lake, but you wouldn't know it now, unless her idea of a day off was frightful fishes, freakish frogs, and phantasmal vistas. Once, this very Taiko drum boomed and blammed as the Kappagaeru fested their festivals. Now, the tune had changed. How many festivals do you know of that are held underwater? When it's a bountiful harvest you're praying for, nothing butters up your gods and ancestors better than lugging around heavy portable shrines. A particularly rowdy festival usually climaxed with Kappagaeru romping about in the dark, forging romances and finding creative ways to increase the Kappagaeru population. Can you just picture it? The pristine water, like glass, nestled in a vast kingdom of green. It was the perfect getaway for two young lovers. The grass by the lake, soft upon the buttocks. Well, let's just say it was a very memorable honeymoon, even for a man full of memorable stories. But those vividly luscious days are lost, like frogs in a blender. When you get as old as me, and the days grow as weary and predictable as they do, you too will be longing for grass on your buttocks. You mark my words. Believe he was given all these arms so that he could come to the rescue of countless worlds.
Well, could he start with our world? Just saying.
Kutaro pressed on, unflinching, across the dangerous lakes, mossy rocks, and aquatic leaves, slashing at the petals on the wind as if composing a wordless poem. Onward our hero sloshed, noting with every sploosh that the rat's purple poison had been splotched all over the place like putrid paint.
I was beautiful once!
Could you shut up once? Middle lantern. It almost looks like one of those paper ones. Huh? What are those? Lantern ghosts?
At the heart of Lake Cedrus, Kutaro came across a group.
Curse that rat! Look at what I have become! I am a tragedy amongst its unfolding.
I hate to pick on the old trout, but aim for that brainless head of hers! Go on, Katara. Blow her head off again. Snap out of it, lady.
Day after day, saddled by croaking Sprog. It wasn't always like this. I was my child. Can you blame me for taking the rat's medicine? Can you?
Yes, we can. All right, one more, Katara.
The rat spell? It's broken? Oh, at last! My former splendor will be restored! Why, Gobs, why? What a fool I was to have listened to that insidious rat!
Well, let that be a lesson. The next time something sounds too good to be true...
Cut you, rat! Cut you! You vile servant of evil! Like the Black Death, you came and blackened the hope in us all! And then you killed us!
You're kind of still alive, you know.
Ew, what gives? Is Gloria off today? I can't work with this ham.
Whoa, 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 whoa with me!
Oh my gosh, this is horrifying! Come on, Katara.
Wait, wait! I'm not finished. The gods of the Moonwood, they are in danger. Grievous danger. More, you are doomed, doomed. The Moonwood's end is assured.
It's grievous, you ignoramus.
Oh, that's it! Stop everything!
Jeez, lady.
Who flushed your muse down the toilet? Curtain! Bill, get her out of here. I'll summarize for the audience.
Okay.
So, basically... Me and Katara are
Cedars! Oh. You must find Mother and Father Cedar at the center of the forest before...
Shut up! Me and Katara have to save the Moonwood's guardian deity.
Whose roots stretch beneath the whole forest. Yes. Oh, line. If Rat convinces them to drink this nefarious... The elixir!
Wait, okay. We're done. Next scene. Yes, Katara, they love you. Now walk!
We are doomed. The forest shall rot. The birds shall chirp their own obituaries. The cataclysm is upon us.
Good day to you, sir and madam. What an honor it is to meet the one and only Mother and Father Cedar.
Aren't you polite? And well spoken, too.
Make yourself at home. You're the talk of the forest, don't you know? They're all raving about that... elixir. What's it you've got?
Ah, yes! The elixir. It cures any ailment.
Ah!
Do tell, sir.
Well, one of us is a little F-A-T.
Ah, I see. But you do not seem so plumpy to me.
I'm not the one of us with the problem. Catch my drift?
Indeed I do. I shall make your wife slender and supple again.
Well, while you're catching his drift...
Yes, madam?
Do you smell that?
Yes, madam. What is that fragrance?
It's not me. Guess who it is?
Say no more. I can make your husband's crag smell as fresh as the cold breeze. Needing is this Glum the Raculexia.
Oh!
Here, allow me to gift you with this limited time free sample. But you must not tell my other customers.
Somebody called 911.
And now the moon wing is doomed.
Desist! Will no one get this grisly dope off me?
His treachery lay there. Rat sprayed Mother and Father Cedar with a revolting violet groove.
Silly shrubberies! Your forest is belonging to the Moon Bear King now!
A few well-placed bombs should blow all that goop off.
For a limited time, buy the one, get one, no, two, free! While supplies last!
Now get it off my husband! Quickly!
On a cedar? That makes absolutely no sense.
I am slashing prices.
Quickly!
is too.
How daring of you!
Sometimes the smallest change can rekindle lost love. But don't worry, it'll get lost again.
For a limited time, buy the one, get one, no, two, free! While supplies last!
Don't forget to do the misses, too!
We never even considered him might be a victim too.
Rotten Moon Bear King. No respect for middle management.
But that's just our opinion.
You don't have to punish the creature on our behalf.
What kindness? What mercy? Oh, I am touching deeply, truly. If you let me squeak by, I will give you whatever you ask. You need only name it.
Well, how about that? You know, the lixamacornet that's supposed to help with the missus's F.A.D. problem.
Yes, the elixir. We've tried everything to cure my husband's pit odor. Nothing works. Just take a whiff.
Then I've only got a surprise for you. Come on round. And welcome to the Rat Waste Shopping Camp.
Whoa. What is going on?
Mother and Father Cedar, how would you like to be getting your hands on this Plum Miraculixir? Getting the stinky pits in old age? Never to wear.
Well, perhaps.
Too much chunk in your trunk? Never to fear.
Oh.
With just one gulp of Plum Miraculixir, you can kiss the problems goodbye. Ever wonder how the Moonbear King got so strong? It's plumb simple, dear. Curious why the Moon Goddess was so beautiful? It's a plumb secret, dear. Guaranteed by the Moony Mage Administration or your money back.
Oh, but it must cost a fortune.
It does. But today is your lucky day. For a limited time, we're offering a 90-day free trial. It will not cost you to die.
Not one dime.
But you had better act now. This offer ends as soon as our program is over. Grab that phone today. Today.
Would you cut it out?
By the way, Kutaro, maybe you could do me a favor. Do you think those scissors of yours could lop a few pounds off the missus?
I said enough!